Good. Thank you, colleagues. I'm going to share the evolving experiences of the Environmental Investment Fund of Namibia for the benefit of those participants who do not know. Namibia is a small country, small, basically only in the size of the population, but a huge geographically big country on the southwestern coast of Namibia. I work for the Environmental Investment Fund, currently the only accredited entity under GCF. We implement a portfolio of four GCF projects, all of them adaptation projects. And I'm going to share our evolving experiences with respect to one of the projects called Empower to Adapt. I will need assistance to get back to the first page, please. Okay, yeah, thank you. Next page now. Basically, why do we consider this project as business unusual? Is the project brings the resources directly to the rural communities to address the local level adaptation needs. It is focuses on bottom-up community-based natural resources governance, supporting locally led approaches to identifying practical adaptation solutions. Institutionalized capacity building makes context-specific programming approaches and solutions possible. A locally led approach in both design and development of projects and through monitoring and evaluation. The locally led community monitoring system is also an essential part of the project that provides feedback loop for enhanced and effective climate change planning and adaptation management. The identified project funding windows, and this is where I need to pause for a second, address critical root causes of vulnerable rural populations whose livelihoods depend directly on natural resources. Namibia is an extremely, as you may have read, an extremely arid country, with about 60 to 70% of the population rurally based, bulk of which directly depend on natural resources for their livelihoods. So these funding windows were basically informed by vulnerability assessment, a national one that was undertaken, that identified key adaptation options for different geographic regions. And the content of these three investment windows, ecosystem-based adaptation, climate-resilient agriculture, and climate-proof infrastructure were informed by this vulnerability assessment. And colleagues will probably notice quite a bit of similarity between this and the first presentation that came from South Africa. Climate change impacts, creating income generating opportunity for women, youth, also contributes to addressing poverty and associated vulnerabilities, basically responding to the needs that have been identified through the National Vulnerability Assessment. It is a grant-based facility that enhances accessibility to finance to local actors. As I alluded to in my introduction, the funding in this case goes directly to community-based entities, which in this case are legally registered and gazetted communal area conservancies and community forest management entities. No obligation for paying back. The difference here, why this is business unusual, is that traditionally in Namibia, they were always our colleagues from the civil society sector that will be in between providing support to the CBOs. But this project is one of the kind, at least in our perspective, that has broken away from that tradition and has invested directly into the CBOs in this case. The CBOs that received support under this project were basically in three types in terms of capacity. There were those that were really capable of managing the resources that were provided to them themselves. They were in the middle, the ones that needed just a little bit of limited external support by support entities of their choice. And then there were very minimal handful of them that were able to basically say, no, guys, we cannot handle this because of our limited capacity, literacy, remote locations. We'd like to have a civil society partner help us out of our request. So that is really what made this one very unique. One of the reasons why this project is also very strong in our opinion is that it's not something that EIF or this GCF resources have started. The project basically capitalized on existing institutional foundation that was laid by Namibia's National CBNRM Program. This program has been operating since 1990s, more than 20 years by the time this project was approved. 80 communal area conservancies registered, over 40 communal forest reserves registered, which have received a lot of support and institutional development over this period. So this project basically chipped in and provided support where the investments and progress that were made under the National CBNRM program were being threatened by climate change. And that is why the local level monitoring element of this project basically also brought in monitoring the impact of climate change on already ongoing monitoring efforts that focused on tourism and biodiversity. Next slide, please. How does this project align to 8 principles of locally led adaptation? The design of the project is the first one, that it is executed by the CBOs, not only executed by plant, conceptualized and implemented by the CBOs. They are at the center of the implementation. This decision-making contributes to ownership, increased ownership actually at that social scalability and rehabilitability of the project, and CBNRM governance is enhanced. The delivery mechanism provides funding directly to CBOs, as I have alluded to earlier, without the need of reliance on intermediaries. Secondly, the grant-based finance is available to the poor, climate vulnerable communities, including the poorest populations, the marginalized groups, providing income generating opportunities and improved livelihoods. The facility investment windows address the needs, and those needs, as I said earlier, informed by very rigorous vulnerability and assessment exercise that was undertaken by the Ministry of Environment and Tourism and key stakeholders. The project provides grant-based finance, again, requiring no collateral, making it accessible to the vulnerable groups, including women and youth, capacity building, and I will come back to capacity building, how it became a challenge in the end. Capacity building is provided to CBOs to ensure that CBOs are equipped with the necessary skills to basically conceptualize and develop projects. The capacity building is also very important that the project emphasizes climate awareness, gender training on proposal, development and access to grant funding, and development of implementation of climate investment plans, and also playing an active role in monitoring and evaluation, as well as meeting the reporting requirements that came with the funding. Maybe I just jump to the slide that deals with challenges. I really joined the South African colleague with the challenges that she listed, but we have our own unique challenges. The first one was the underestimation of, not on our part, but on the part of the colleagues from the GCF, of the need of capacity building. it was considered as non-climate change and as a result not adequately capitalized. That was the biggest challenge, and also the expectations and dealing with the political stakeholders, as the colleague from Zimbabwe has also, and Kenya also have outlined. But from that, there were also a host of opportunities in this respect. We built on an existing foundation, institutional foundation of the National CBNRM program. And then also we found ready-made institutional capacity on the ground, which we have added through this project. So basically taking the resources directly to where the needs are experienced on the ground. Thank you.